Hi, my name is Michelle Embleton, and today we're going to look at what happens to the excess unused embryos after IVF treatment. In an IVF treatment, as we know, we take the eggs from the woman and fertilize them with the sperm from the man outside of the woman's body. Then the resultant embryos are grown in the lab for a few days before transferred into the woman. The number of embryos transferred depends on various factors, which we'll discuss later. We're going to look at today what happens to the embryos that aren't transferred into the woman's uterus. We're going to have a look at what is the origin of these surplus embryos, how many embryos are transferred, what is the fate of frozen human embryos, and the renewal of consent for storage. When we perform an IVF treatment, whether we do this in a conventional IVF treatment or we use intracytoplasmic sperm injection, the aim of the procedure is to produce as many good quality embryos as possible. Not all of the embryos produced will be eventually transferred into the woman's uterus. The two main reasons for this are government legislation or laws which govern how many embryos can be transferred and the intention to avoid multiple pregnancy. Nowadays, we have excellent cryopreservation techniques which allow us to freeze or vitrify the embryos without compromising their survival rate. This, in combination with the fact that nowadays we tend to do more single embryo transfers, means there are more embryos that can be preserved cryogenically effectively without compromising their quality. So we have quite a few leftover embryos. Most countries have the same kind of governing laws and regulations about how many embryos are transferred in an IVF treatment. In general, and to avoid multiple pregnancy, one or two embryos are transferred. The younger the woman and the better quality the embryo, less embryos are transferred. So, for example, if the woman is 32 years old and has excellent embryo qualities, only one would be advisable to be transferred. However, it is a combination as well of talking to your health provider, your fertility specialist, and your wishes. Only in very few cases are three embryos transferred, and these tend to be in cases of poor embryo quality and in advanced maternal age. After the decision on how many embryos to be transferred is made, we also need to look at what is going to happen to the leftover embryos from the IVF process. Most countries have similar laws governing what can happen to these embryos, and generally there are four main options. One is to preserve them cryogenically for your own future use. For example, if implantation doesn't occur and pregnancy is not achieved, you now have some frozen embryos for you to try again in the future without having to undergo the process of ovarian stimulation. Also, if your pregnancy has been successful and you now have a child, you may want to have brothers and sisters for that child in the future. You can now have embryos in storage, which you can use for an embryo implantation at a later date. If in the future you decide that your family is complete and you're not going to use the embryos for your own purposes, you can decide to donate the embryos. The first option here is to donate these to another couple who are trying for pregnancy. Obviously, it will undergo the same kind of laws as for egg donation. In most countries, it will be a totally anonymous and altruistic process. You can also donate your frozen embryos to research purposes to help research advance the field of assisted reproduction. Anyone deciding to donate their embryos for research purposes will be informed of the specific project and required to sign the appropriate consent. The final option for the fate of these unused embryos is the cessation of their storage. Basically, you decide that they are not going to be stored anymore and they will go for destruction. Once your fertility clinic has explained to you the four options for these frozen leftover embryos, you will be required to sign all the consent forms before starting your IVF treatment. The most commonly chosen destination for the leftover embryos is obviously being frozen for later use. Any embryos in storage have to undergo a renewal of consent. For example, in the UK, every 5 years, the clinic will need to contact you to get your consent that they can keep your embryos in storage. In Spain, this will happen every 2 years. One of the problems that we have in assisted reproduction with the leftover embryos is that people are not renewing their consent for storage. After they have finished their IVF process, their IVF journey, maybe they have their family and don't respond to the communications from the clinic about the fate of the embryos they have in storage. In the United States, this is a very controversial issue as more and more embryos are being found in storage. And the question is what to do with these leftover human embryos. In the UK and Spain, if the renewal of consent is not signed, the embryos will eventually go for destruction. Now we're going to have a look at a couple of the most frequently asked questions from our readers and answer them for you. Well, the answer to this is no. In an artificial insemination, a woman's eggs are not extracted. She undergoes ovarian stimulation of a milder form to mature one or two of her eggs, which then, when they are ready, will be induced for ovulation and the artificial insemination will be performed. Hence, there won't be any eggs for the laboratory. Embryos will not be formed outside of the body, so there will be no leftover embryos. Basically, the success rates of undergoing a second IVF and using your frozen embryos are more or less the same. And a second IVF would mean undergoing ovarian stimulation, follicular puncture, where was the ovum pickup, the IVF in the laboratory, and then the frozen embryo transfer. However, just using frozen embryo transfer would be using the frozen embryos that you previously stored. With thanks to our current techniques of embryo vitrification, where the vast majority of the embryos survive without any problems, there is no need usually to undergo a second round of IVF and then transfer fresh embryos. You may choose to do so, but it isn't usually necessary. The advantage of using your frozen unused embryos is that you don't have to undergo a second round of ovarian stimulation and follicular puncture, taking all the medications. And likewise, there is also a saving as you don't need to go through this first process again. We would like to hear about your experiences, so please do leave a comment below. And if you have liked this video and you found it informative, please click like and subscribe so you don't miss any of our future videos. And I would like to remind you, in the link below, in the description below, you can find a link for the article where you can read more about this topic.